I remember the first time I experienced the death of a significant person in my life. It was probably about 20 years ago. One of my great aunts died, one that I was somewhat close to. And I remember some of the thoughts that came to my mind after she passed. You know, the experience of losing someone who has been a part of your life for a long time calls to mind all these questions about what we believe and what is this reality that we're experiencing, death. And I remember the basic question in my mind was, you know, where is she now? This person who was connected to so many others throughout her life, who loved other people, who had children, who served other people, who had faith, who affected so many lives. Could it be that now that she is dead, there is nothing more for her? Could it be that after death, there is nothing more than simply to lie in the grave? I think I came to the realization at that point that I must believe that there is something more, that if there is to be any sense of living, if there is any purpose or any meaning about having been given this gift of life, then it cannot terminate by just lying in the grave. There must be more. This is almost the end of our liturgical year. It's the 33rd Sunday in Ordinary Time, a time in the church year when we meditate on last things, final things. We heard about the end of the world. We heard questions in the gospel about how will we know when all of this created world will come to its completion? What signs will be given that the world will come to its end, that Jesus will come back to us? And Jesus gives some indications, but his more important lesson is that no matter what happens, and awful things will happen, people will be persecuted for their faith. Family members will hand over family members for persecution to the point of death because of their faith. But Jesus says, do not be afraid, because not a hair on your head will be destroyed. That is the great promise and benefit of faith. That belief that no matter what happens, that even if death should come to us, and how often does death come at a time when it is not expected? Our loved ones are taken from us in an instant, and we don't expect it. But in faith, that tragedy is not a crisis that breaks us, because we believe that God will secure life for us. As we meditate on the last things in the Lord's return, let us pray that if it should happen today or tomorrow or in 1,000 years, that when it is our time, the Lord will find us standing ready, vigilant in faith, and serving others in charity, that no matter when he comes, we will be ready to join him in heaven.